I'm Norman Wildberger. Today we're going to construct conics via projective geometry. There are in fact many different ways of constructing conics, through equations, through slicing a cone, through various metrical constructions, some involving pieces of string. But the approach through projective geometry is particularly elegant and in some sense very simple. So a conic for us is something like a circle, parabola, ellipse, hyperbola, or even a pair of lines. There's a parabola roughly, a circle and ellipse, a hyperbola which has two branches, and a pair of lines is some kind of degenerate conic which is often included also. So this family of objects is very, very important in mathematics, and we'll have a lot more to say about these things as our course develops. But this is some initial contact with these things in terms of a construction. We've been talking a lot about perspectivities in the last few lectures. Let me remind you that if you have a line L1 and a line L2, then a perspectivity is obtained by taking a point O outside them and connecting lines from O through L1 and touching L2. That associates then this point on L1 with this point on L2. This point on L1 with this point on L2. This point with this point, and this point, and so on. And that gives an association of all the points on L1 with all the points on L2. And to make that statement precise, I remind you that we also have to include that special point at infinity that's on each of the lines. Because, for example, if you take this line through O, it intersects our line L2 at this point, but it's actually parallel to L1. So unless you have that point at infinity, then these wouldn't correspond. But with the point at infinity on L1, that would correspond to this point on L2. And similarly, this point on L1 would correspond to the point at infinity on L2. Now, it turns out that there's a complete duality between this kind of perspectivity and a quite a different perspectivity between pencils. So if we have a point A1, then we talk about the pencil of lines through A1. All the lines through A1, and here's the pencil of lines through A2. And we can talk about a perspectivity between this pencil and this pencil in an exactly dual way. So what do we need? Instead of having a point of perspectivity, we need a line of perspectivity. So let's suppose we're given a line, L. How do we use that line? Well, then for any line in the pencil at A1, we look to see where it intersects L, and where it meets, we join to A2 to get an element of the pencil from A2. This line is connected with this line. This line is connected with this one with this one. We get an association between all the lines through A1 and all the lines through A2. So we're going to use both of these to construct what Steiner calls line conics and point conics. This is work of the 19th century by one of the great German geometers. And what we're going to do to show you this is we're going to use the Geometer's Sketchpad, which is a commercial software, which is a lovely addition to your tool chest. I'm not officially affiliated with these people, but it's a really lovely product. And we're going to show you how to use that software to demonstrate some diagrams illustrating the constructions of these conics. This Geometer's Sketchpad worksheet shows us the effect of our projectivity between points on L1 and points on L3. That projectivity is accomplished by two perspectivities. The first, with center O1, takes points on L1 and transforms them to points on L2, this intermediate black line. The second perspectivity, with center O2, takes a point on L2 and associates it to a point on L3. And as we vary, say A1, we can see how A2 and A3 vary correspondingly. Now, to get a conic, what we do is we join the first point to the last point in this projectivity. We join that with this dotted line, and now we watch what happens to that dotted line as we vary A1. Well, I wonder if you can see what kind of shape that line is traversing. It's actually enveloping a curve, and we can find out what that is by doing a locus function. So we'll press that and select that, and we'll construct the locus. This is a beautiful feature of the Geometer Sketchpad. So now what we have is a whole bunch of representatives of our dotted line as we swing through various positions of A1. And we see that we get an ellipse being enveloped by this family of lines. So it's a way of getting a, what's called a line conic from a projectivity between two lines. And if we move things around, if we move this point of perspectivity, we can vary not only the shape of the ellipse, but we can also make it into a hyperbola. And it's very interesting to try to understand the relationship between the various ingredients and the output conic that we're achieving. Now let's look at the dual situation where we're considering a pencil of lines through A1 and a pencil of lines through A3 connected with a projectivity between pencils now this time. So that's accomplished by first of all using L1 as a line of perspectivity between the pencil at A1 and the pencil at A2. So how does that work? Well, you take a random line through A1, say that one there, you see where it intersects L1, and you use that point to pick out an element in the pencil at A2. So if we move this variable point, we can see that lines through A1 are connected or correspond to lines in through A2. And then we do the same kind of thing using the line L2 as a line of perspectivity between the pencil here and the pencil here, so that this line through A2 gets matched up with this line through A3. That then gives a correspondence between the line that we started with through A1 and the line that we end up with through A3, between this line and this line. And now to get a conic, what we do is we look at the intersection of those two lines. Just as we looked at the join of two points before, now we look at the intersection or the meet of these two lines. And this point up here, we look to see where it goes as we move this point. Can you see what it's doing? Partially. Whoa, it's coming down there. All right, let's have a look at this locus operation. If we select this one and select this one and construct a locus, what we see is we get an ellipse, part of an ellipse. And if we vary these various ingredients, the line, then the ellipse can change its nature, and it can even become a hyperbola in either direction. This is called a point conic. So we're obtaining a point conic as the result of a projectivity between two pencils of lines, between A1 and A3, and looking where that common intersection point traverses as we go through all the pencils at A1. Next time, we're going to go back to basics and have a look at some algebraic framework for rational trigonometry. This will be a good chance to refresh and review some of the formulas which you may be a little rusty with. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wahlberger. Thanks for listening.